Our company has been around now for 82 years, and it's not so much that we truly changed the strategy, but we had a big crisis in 2009, so something has to happen. And actually what we did at that time is not so much change our strategy as making sure that our implicit strategy became more articulate, that everybody knew what we were doing, and being more consequent.
Stick to your strategy, very important, until you need a new one. Don't get caught up in your strategy, because the strategy is something you think up usually when you don't have all the information. In many companies, in order to switch their strategy, they have to break down what they've done before. We have a different philosophy. What we have is what we call version 503. I'm not quite sure what we do. What we do is that we new releases of our philosophy.
It's about the why you do things, and not in particularly what do we do and how much money do we make. I think motivation of people is the most potent driver that you can have.
Implementing these ideas is not about telling people how to think, it's about sharing ideas and inspiring people. And the moment they really truly believe in ideas, they will just internalize those ideas as well, and they will spread it throughout the organization themselves.
He's really doing a smart job in focusing on what talent he needed and picking out the right person for the right job.
It's focus from the beginning to the end. The message and presentation of the company is exactly what he does and he want to sell. So I think he's a brand ambassador of his company.
I liked his personal approach, that he was really focusing on say how you build a new organization within NetApp, which is independent from key figures or from profit margins or turnover. I came for the man, and the man had a great story to tell, and I loved it.